The topic for today in your paper 9 is suffering. First, we will see its definition, and then there are some theorems, and after that, we will have some examples. So let us first see sufferings. See its definition. Let R be a ring. Here, R is a ring. This is our first condition. A non-empty subset S of the set R. We have a non-empty subset S of the R. Then this subset S will set to be a subring of R if S is closed with respect to the operations of addition and multiplication in R. And S itself is a ring for these operations. Suppose the operations of addition and multiplication are plus and dot, then S is closed with respect to addition means A, if A and B both are in S, then A plus B will be in S. And operation of multiplication is if A and B belongs to S, then A into B is also in S. So these are two operations, and S is closed with respect to these two operations, and S itself is a ring for these operations. Means S, the set S satisfies the properties of a ring. Means what are the properties? S plus is a ring, is an abelian group, and for any three elements A, B, C, A into B plus C is AB plus AC, and B plus C into A is BA plus CA. So you just remember those things, and you would have seen my YouTube lectures, group and ring 4, 5, and 6. There, the definition of ring with some examples are given. See, if S is a subring of a ring R, then it is obvious that S is a subgroup of the additive group of R. Since R plus is a group, is an abelian group, and S plus is also an abelian group. And since S is a subset, therefore S will be a subgroup. For if R is any ring, then the set containing element 0 only and R itself, these are always subrings of R. They are called improper subrings. And other subrings of R, they will be called proper subrings of R. Now there are some theorems for proving that a given subset is a subring or not. These are very important. See the theorem. The necessary and sufficient conditions for a non-empty subset S of a ring R to be a subring of R are: A belongs to S, B belongs to S, implies that A minus B belongs to S, and A belongs to S, B belongs to S, implies that A into B belongs to S. So these two conditions are necessary and sufficient condition. If any subset satisfies these two conditions, then that subset will be treated as a subring. Or if S is any subring, then it will satisfy these two conditions. Let us see its proof. First, we will see that the conditions are necessary. It means we will take S plus dot as a subring and prove these two conditions. And the conditions are sufficient, we will take these two conditions to be true, and using these two conditions, we will prove that S plus dot is a subring. See here, suppose S plus dot is a subring of R plus dot. So since S is a group with respect to addition, therefore B belongs to S implies that minus B will also be in S. Why? Because S is a group. Now S plus dot is a subring means S plus is an abelian group, so S is obviously a group. Now S is closed with respect to addition. This is given in the condition of the theorem that it should be closed. It should be closed with respect to operation of addition and multiplication in the definition of subring. So A belongs to S, B belongs to S implies A belongs to S and minus B belongs to S. It implies that A plus minus B belongs to S because S is closed with respect to addition. So A plus minus B belongs to S, it means A minus B belongs to S. The first condition is fulfilled. Second, since S is closed with respect to multiplication, therefore A belongs to S, B belongs to S implies A into B belongs to S. So this condition is also fulfilled. Means both conditions are satisfied. Therefore, the conditions are necessary. Next, we will take the conditions are sufficient. Suppose S is a non-empty subset of R and the conditions 1 and 2 are satisfied. So using these, we need to show that S plus dot is a subring. From 1, we have A belongs to S, B belongs to S, implies A minus A belongs to S. See here your first condition. From this condition, take B is equal to A. So A belongs to S, A belongs to S, implies A minus A belongs to S, means 0 belongs to S. This is the 0 element in S. Now, since 0 belongs to S, therefore, from 1, you will have what? 0 belongs to S and A belongs to S, and implies 0 minus A belongs to S from condition 1. It means minus A is in S. It means the each element of S possesses additive inverse. This minus A is the additive inverse of A, and it is in S. We have taken A earlier, A in S. Therefore, each element of S possesses its additive inverse. Now, if AB are any elements of S, then minus B belongs to S. Therefore, from 1, we have A minus A belongs to S, minus B belongs to S, implies A minus B belongs to S. It means A plus B belongs to S. Therefore, S is closed with respect to addition. We have proved this one also. Now, S is a subset of R. Since this S is a subset of R, therefore, associativity and commutativity of addition must hold in S, since they hold in R, no doubt. Since S is also a group, and in a group, we must have associativity. And since S is an abelian group, we must have commutativity also. Therefore, S plus is an abelian group. Also, it is given that S is a subset of R, which has associative and commutativity. So S plus is an abelian group. Now, from 2, S is closed with respect to multiplication. Associativity of multiplication and distributive of multiplication over addition must hold in S. Why? Because they hold in R, and S is a subset of R, so S will also have these two properties. So this set S satisfies all the properties of a subring, means S plus is a ring, S plus is an abelian group, and S is associativity of multiplication and distributive of multiplication over addition, both of them hold true in S. Therefore, this S is a subring of R. So we have proved that the necessary and sufficient condition for a non-empty subset S of a ring R to be a subring is that A belongs to S, B belongs to S, implies A minus B belongs to S, and A belongs to S, B belongs to S, implies A into B belongs to S. So this completes your first theorem. Next, we have another theorem, intersection of subrings. See theorem. The intersection of two subrings is a ring. The intersection of two subrings is a subring. So you can see let us see its proof. Suppose we have S1 and S2 as two subrings of a ring R. Then S1 intersection S2 is not empty, since at least 0 belongs to S1 intersection S2. At least 0 will be a common element of S1 and S2. So S1 intersection S2 is not empty. Next, in order to prove that S1 intersection S2 is a subring as per the given theorem, it is sufficient to prove that A belongs to S1 intersection S2, B belongs to S1 intersection S2, implies A minus B belongs to S1 intersection S2. And second, A belongs to S1 intersection S2, B belongs to S1 intersection S2, implies A into B belongs to S1 intersection S2. This we got from our just earlier proved theorem. So we will use the condition of Dodd theorem and prove that S1 intersection S2 is also a subring. See, we have A belongs to S1 intersection S2. It means it implies that A belongs to S1 and A belongs to S2. Why? Because it is in the intersection of both these sets. And B belongs to S1 intersection S2, implies B belongs to S1 and B belongs to S2. Since S1 and S2 are both subrings, therefore A belongs to S1 and B belongs to S1. See, from here, A in S1, and B is in S1. So A in S1 and B in S1 implies that A minus B is in S1 and AB is in S1. Why? Because S1 is a subring. Similarly, A belongs to S2 and B belongs to S2 implies A minus B belongs to S2. And AB belongs to S2. So see here, A minus B belongs to S1 and A minus B belongs to S2. So A minus B belongs to intersection of S1 and S2. Similarly, AB belongs to S1 and AB belongs to S2. It means AB will be in their intersection. So now what we have, thus A belongs to S1 intersection S2 here. That A minus B belongs to S1, A minus B belongs to S2, implies A minus B belongs to S1 intersection S2. And AB belongs to S1, AB belongs to S2, implies AB belongs to S1 intersection S2. Means A belongs to S1 intersection S2, B belongs to S1 intersection S2, implies A minus B belongs to S1 intersection S2, and AB belongs to S1 intersection S2. So we have proved the both the conditions. It means, therefore, S1 intersection S2 will be a subring of R. So this theorem is also proved. There is another theorem. Let us see this theorem also. An arbitrary intersection of subrings is a subring. Means here we have taken intersection of only two subrings. But now we are taking an arbitrary intersection. Means there may be more than two subrings. So an arbitrary intersection of subrings is a subring. Let us see its proof. Let R be a ring and let ST, where T belongs to capital T, be any family of subrings of R. Here this T is a is an index set. Suppose this T is your set of integers. So this is small t varies from 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So this ST means S1, S2, S3, and so on. So R is a ring and there are S1, S2, and S3, and so on, plenty of subrings of R. Here this T is a is an index set and it's such that for all T in capital T, for all T in capital T, S is a subring of R. Let us take intersection of all those subrings. Means S is written as intersection over T in capital T, ST. Means it will contain all the elements of X in R such that X belongs to ST for all small t in capital T. So this is be the intersection of this family of subrings of R. So we need to show that this is also, this S is also a subring. Then to prove that S is also a subring of R. See, obviously S is not equal to 5 since at least the zero element of R is in ST. Since all ST will contain a small element 0. So this S, which is intersection of all ST, will contain at least the zero element of R. Therefore, this S is not equal to 5. Now let A be, there are two any elements of S. Then A belongs to intersection ST over T, implies that A belongs to ST for all T in capital T, and B belongs to intersection ST over T, implies that B belongs to ST for all T over T, capital T. But for all small t over capital T, ST is a subring of R. It is, we have taken ST to be a subring of R. Therefore, AB belongs to ST, implies A minus B belongs to ST, and A into B belongs to ST for all small t in capital T. Since this is true for all T in capital T, therefore, consequently, A minus B and AB, A minus B belongs to intersection over T, capital T, ST, and AB belongs to intersection of all ST, T belongs to capital T. Thus, we have shown that AB belongs to intersection over T in capital T, ST implies that A minus B belongs to intersection over T in capital T, ST, and AB in, belongs to intersection over T in capital T, ST. So, this ST satisfies both the conditions of our first theorem. So this intersection over T in capital T, ST is a subring of R. So we have proved that arbitrary intersection of subrings of a ring R is a subring. So this is all about for you today. We will discuss some of the examples in our next class. So till now, you need to just note down it in your note copy and we will discuss in another class the examples.